Hello everyone, I'm Joseph again, STEM professor Assam Downtown University. In this video I am going to explain about paper chromatography. So what are the steps involved in paper chromatography and what is the principle involved in paper chromatography I'm going to discuss in this video. So let's see. In introduction part, like, paper chromatography was introduced by the Sonnenwein in 1865 under the name capillary analysis, and paper chromatography became popular only when a team of Consden, Gordon, Martin and Cheins in England in 1944 done a outstanding work. So after that, principle involved in this paper chromatography is partition chromatography. Paper chromatography is defined as a technique where the separation of mixture occurs of different substances. It's mainly done by the flow of solvents on a Wattmann chromatography filter paper. Then stationary phase and mobile phase is there. For stationary phase, water present in cellulose of the filter paper, and the mobile phase is an organic solvent which is immiscible with the stationary phase. Then mobile phase rises by capillary action and by adsorption on a filter paper, and the separation is achieved by the differential migration of the different component which occur due to the differences in partition coefficient. So theory behind this paper chromatography is already I have told the principle, the partition chromatography. Then two types of forces operate when a drop of solution is applied on the filter paper and treated with a mobile phase. There is propelling force and retarding force. This propelling force means it tries to drag the substance in the direction of the flow of the mobile phase, that is solvent. And this depends upon the rate of the solvent flow and the solubility of the substance in the solvent. After that we have a retarding force. Here RF, it tries to drag the substance behind towards its point of application. This retardation depends on the adsorption and the partition. So types of paper chromatography, there are two types. One is paper partition chromatography and one is paper adsorption chromatography. In case of paper partition chromatography, the substance say in a mixer move into two non-mixing solvent and create partition between them. And paper adsorption chromatography, the filter paper is impregnated with an adsorbent such as alumina or silica, and a single solvent is allowed to flow over the unknown component. So techniques of paper chromatography, we need to take a filter paper, then after that we have to prepare the solution, then application of sample into the paper, then we have to take the mobile phase, that choice of solvent, and we have to develop one chromatogram, need to dry it and locate the spot of the compound in the paper. So these are the filter paper, this Wattmann filter paper, you can see these type of filter papers are there for paper chromatography. Then preparation of paper, we need to cut the paper into desired shape or size depending upon work to be carried out. If you are going to apply more than two or three sample in a single paper, the paper size will be obviously bigger. Like that we have to cut the paper. And the most common shape of the filter paper is rectangular, although the square paper can also be used, and 15 to 30 centimeter in the length and 1 to several centimeter in width. Then the starting the line is marked on the paper with an ordinary pencil 2 centimeter from the bottom edge. On starting line, marks are made 2 centimeter apart from each other, because the starting line is marked on the paper with an ordinary pencil, that is 2 centimeter from the bottom edge, because we are going to dip this paper in the mobile phase. So because of this it may means dissolve this compound from the spot of the sample, so we need to spot the sample above the mobile phase layer. it should not be dipped in the mobile phase of the tank. So only because of this we need to starting make the starting line above 2 cm. After that preparation of the solution is there, so we need to prepare the solution with suitable solvent for making the solution. So pure solutions can be applied directly on the filter paper, but solids are also always dissolved, so we can directly cannot like use solids. Then biological tissues are treated with a suitable solvent and they are extract obtained. Large amount of the protein and salts are often present in the biological extract, which interfere with the partitioning the process, and proteins can be precipitated with alcohol and salt, can be removed by treatment with ion exchange resin or by an electrolytic method. In my next video, I'm going to explain the next techniques involved in this paper chromatography. Thank you.